After 3 billion years of evolution, we hit an evolutionary dead end. We're Ardipithecus ramidus, 4 feet tall, at 80 pounds, with a brain the size of an orange. Our dense rainforest home has become patchy forest. We can stand on branches, move along them. But to reach more food, we need to let go. Million years ago. These are our first steps on two legs. Walking takes us to the food and leaves our hands free to pick it. It catches on, fast. Ardipithecus is smart enough to copy and learn. Walking gets passed from parent to child. Over the next 1.2 million years, our body evolves so that we can walk further and faster. Finding shelter, a mate, and food gets easier, but childbirth gets harder. With a narrower pelvis, giving birth to a fully developed infant becomes impossible. Babies have to come out early, when their heads are smaller and they're barely developed. That's why we are one of the few species to spend years caring for our offspring, protecting them, feeding them, and keeping them out of trouble. Million years ago, we're an Australopithecine. Our brain is the size of a grapefruit, and we walk on two legs all the time. We got lucky. The lion has already eaten. This time. We can't outrun our predators. The only way to survive is to outthink them. The smarter we get, the longer we live. Natural selection promotes the mutations that improve our brain power. Like weaker jaw muscles. Released from the muscle's vice-like grip, the brain is free to grow. It doubles in size. Million years ago, this is Homo habilis, also known as handyman. Walking on two legs with a big brain, we're the first of an entirely new type of creature. We're the first man. We're bigger, stronger, and hungrier than ever before. There's food out there, but it's more likely to eat us before we can eat it. We're a scavenger. Working alone, we eat whatever we can find. The edge is razor sharp. We have just made the very first tool. Armed with this, we will change the world. East Africa, 2.3 million years ago. After over 3 billion years of evolution, we take our fate into our own hands. We are the first species to make tools. In this hostile environment, we need every advantage we can get. We must fight off predators, starvation, and our own relatives. There's no meat left. It looks like we're going hungry again. But there's bone marrow locked inside, packed with energy. The tool is the key to a whole new way of life. We'll use it to grow crops, build cities, and travel into space. Our thumbs become stronger. Hold a cup, pick up a pen. We can do this because 2 million years ago, tool use changed our bodies and the course of evolution. We've pieced together our ancestors' story from their bones. But from the vastness of Africa, all the bones of our early human ancestors ever found would fit into the back of a pickup. Less than one bone in a billion becomes a fossil. Factor in the chances of finding those bones across millions of square miles, and it's clear. Most of what has lived has been lost. Our family tree is a giant puzzle, with most of the pieces missing. But 1.8 million years ago, a piece falls into place, and we find a new species on the scene, Homo erectus. Until this point, we were scavengers, but now we're hunters. And we've learned how to work with other members of our species. The hunt is on. The impala can run fast, but we can run further. Low shoulders and long torsos stabilize us. Powerful buttock muscles contract, expand, and push us forwards. Sweat stops us from overheating. Covered in fur, the impala is exhausted. Fire. It sparks an idea that will make our ancestors human. Warmth, light, safety is within reach. Nature's power is in our hands. Protected from the terrors of the dark, our extended family gather round. By working together, these earliest families get food more often, so we live longer. This is the advantage of family life, the reason most of us live as we do today. Meat is too precious to waste. And cooked meat is easier to chew. The powerful molars used to chew tough raw food retreat back into the gums, where they'll stay as our wisdom teeth. 35% of us never even grow them, a sign that they may be evolving out of existence. With less energy spent on chewing, our ancestors have energy to spare. The brain increases to the size of a softball, 50% larger than before the invention of cooking. Erectus is the cleverest, most cooperative ancestor to date. But with several adult males in an extended family, rivalries are inevitable. Communicate and will live longer. Natural selection kicks in. Our tongue changes shape and moves down our throat, carrying the larynx with it, allowing us to form different shapes in our mouths, making different sounds, and ultimately, words. Speech is our greatest tool. It's the last piece of the puzzle that turns our ancestors into us. 200,000 years ago, after a 3.3 billion year battle for survival, we've arrived. We are Homo sapiens, meaning wise man. Pound for pound, we have the largest brain of any creature on Earth. Armed with tools, speech, and superior intelligence, we spread out across every continent. We evolve and adapt to new environments, new challenges, until we become the undisputed masters of the world. Wind the clock of life back to the beginning, and the chances of us evolving again are practically zero. Change one thing, one predator, one lucky mutation, and we wouldn't be here to tell the tale, to piece together the extraordinary story of our 4 billion year journey.